So this is a protest that is happening in the last 8 days in Liberty Square. This is the corner of Liberty Street and Broadway, just a couple blocks from Wall Street. And these guys, people of all ages and walks of life, are joining efforts to protest the current economical and political system of the United States. This is a growing movement that is happening all across the United States, and I decided to come today and take a look of who are these people. Obviously they are very idealistic and hopeful individuals who believe that things need to change.
This is day 8.
Day 8. And why is this not in the proper news media?
Oh, it's starting to be. The bigger we get, the more media we're starting to get. At first, they thought we were kidding. They thought we would. The rain would make us go home. They thought the police would scare us. They didn't think we would last. But now we've been here over a week. They know we're serious.
How many people do you calculate approximately for the protest?
Right now on the march, over 1,000. Mm-hmm. Maybe even 2,000 people.
And you guys are all from New York City?
No, I'm from California.
California, you came from, what about yourself?
I'm from Long Island.
Oh, Rhode Island, okay.
Long Island, which is east of here.
Yeah, and most of these people here are young people.
A lot of them are.
We've also got
a lot of older people as well.
Okay, but what's the message, what's the main goal of these brothers?
It's basically a lot of people who are unhappy with the way that things have been going, and we're trying to have a way to figure it all out. You know, we're holding general assemblies, and it's great. It's real true democracy that's going on over here.
Yeah, so. But what's the purpose of it? You guys, what do you want the government to do?
You know what? The government's not going to do anything. Mm-hmm. We need to wake the people up. That's what we're trying to do. The government is ignoring us. We're trying to wake the people up to either vote them out or start this shit over again.
Which is basically a revolution, like,
yes.
Even if it takes violence, I mean...
No, we want to stay non-violent, but that's just us. Who knows what the people in Detroit might do? They might get violent. It might lead to more violence.
So there's another protest in Detroit?
There's Detroit, there's Atlanta, there's San Francisco, Los Angeles, Madrid, Spain, Paris, France, Portland. All over the world, people are having protests just like this one.
Great. You guys now are going to Union Square, where there's a rally, right?
Yes. Yeah. We got reports that the police are gassing the march and spraying pepper spray and using tasers.
How many people have been detained so far since you started?
A lot.
Didn't they have it on the ticker that there were at least 26?
At least 26.
26.
And you should.
More today. I witnessed three today.
And usually they are very violent.
For the most part, yes.
Yeah, and what are the reasons for detaining them?
They can.
Keep walking, or get in the bus.
Listen, no, you gotta keep walking. You keep moving one foot.
And have you ever had any confrontation with people, bypassers, who don't agree with what you guys do?
Most people who pass by us are part of us, whether they're here or not. We're fighting for their rights. We're fighting for them. So most people do agree with us. Some people don't. No, we haven't really had anybody actually come up to us.
And how do you do to survive? I mean, food, shelter?
We have a committee for food. We have a committee for shelter. They go out and get sleeping bags and blankets and sweaters. And
your teacher said Iraq veterans. Were you in Iraq?
Yes.
Really? How long were you there?
I did two deployments, and one in 2005 and one in 2007.
And the things that you saw there, do you think there's actually a war for democracy or for the interests of the United States people?
No. It's imperialism. We're there for the resources. We're there to control the people, to put puppets in. We don't care about democracy. We don't care about their freedom. The United States, we don't have friends. We have interests.
Yeah. Absolutely. And the United States government, I mean, I have friends who say, wait, why do you criticize the United States? If you don't like it, why don't you return to your country? I mean,
I am an American, and I am a veteran. I have every right to...
No, I'm speaking on a personal level, but my question to you is, does the U.S. government represent the United States people?
No, not at all. The United States people are tired of our government. We're tired of being ignored. We're tired of our voice not being heard. This is not a democracy. These people own our politicians, period. No matter how you put it, this is not a democracy.
And you're trying to change that no matter what. Okay, thank you so much, guys.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Hey, tell me what's going on here, how things are after 8 days here in Liberty Square.
Well, 300 people strong have held it down. They've stayed here every night despite rainy conditions, stormy conditions, sometimes lack of food. We've gotten an amazing influx, amazing inpouring of assistance from around the world saying, you've got to hold your ground. We're on our way. Well, I'll tell you what. They weren't lying. We've got a 2,000 strong crowd coming. We've got 500 people here. We're probably going to be pushing 4,000 to 5,000 people tonight. That's a lot of people up in New York City.
And you guys sleeping here?
We have been sleeping here and holding this square as a position to let the world know we will open dialogue with Wall Street. We will demand accountability for your transactions. You will not strip the earth and her people of their resources any longer for your own profit margins.
Now, any corporate media news has come and interview you or get your opinion at all?
Yes, I've been interviewed by NBC, The Guardian, from the UK.
My two friends are down there.
Yeah, I believe ABC. I'm losing track at this point. Fox News early on, but they all disappeared. Some of them put a spin on the story. You know, it's just a little dance party. This, that, or the other. No. I think people know by now that most of the major media is owned by big corporations, and they're desperate to keep the voice down. They're desperate to keep the power of the people from rising up. And, you know, a lot of us feel like these are the last days where we can stand up and actually make a significant difference and our voice be heard and the changes be enacted that we need to see in order for prosperity for the entire earth, for the entire world. So we've held it down. We're about to have a general assembly here in a few minutes with approximately 5,000 people, and we'll see how it goes. So far, it's incredible. We do have 50-plus people arrested in today's march. We have some of our peer leaders, which are called facilitators for the group. We don't have any leaders in this group. What we do is we all work together. We make decisions together on a consensus basis. And we have had some of those peer facilitators taken out pretty quickly out of the march as if they were targeted. We have lawyers representing, but we accept all law assistance. We want as many people working on this as we can. So right now, we just have to deal with the moment. We have one of the most incredible movements in the United States of America happening right now. And so we just got to stay focused and help everybody to be able to voice their opinion.
Last question. Do you see this movement growing?
Yes. I see this movement growing to 20,000 strong by Tuesday.
And you're not
going to
stop.
People are not going to let this happen.
No, let me ask you this question. You guys are sacrificing and leaving your jobs or whatever you guys do in your personal life. Why do you do this?
Because I love my country and I love humanity, and desperate measures to me.
It's a very, very critical moment right now.
Yes, it is. It's a critical moment around the world. It's a critical moment for all of us, knowing that we're going to lose our livelihood, that we've already lost a good portion of our prosperity and any hope for the future and our future generations. So, yes, we are feeling like pressure, so we must do something now.
I have friends who are more worried about their careers and how much money they're going to make in the future, and they don't want to compromise their background checks and all that.
Sure. I think that is a sentiment that is changing. It's a transitional sentiment where a lot of people are a little bit hesitant to join this movement. The Occupy Wall Street movement itself is symbolic of the people's voice and our demand to be heard on a large scale. And we will not accept this tyranny of attempting to put us down every time we want to express our First Amendment rights to a free speech, to just dissent the process that is currently in place.
Word. From our detained brothers and sisters
that they would
stay home and unify.
And those that want to speak to the press.
And those that want to speak to the press.
The outreach under the red structure at 5:45.
Under the red structure at 5:45.
I love you all. Stay safe.
Mic check.
Mic check.
Mic check.
Mic check.
Mic check. Make sure we all
How do you guys organize yourselves with food and drinks? I mean, do you work with donations or regular people?
Donations. Everything that you see here has been through donations.
And if anybody wants to help you, how can they contact you? They need to come here. They need to come here.
Or I've heard that a few people have been donating pizzas by ordering them and then telling them the delivery goes here.
Okay. All right then. How is everything?
Everything's going great. I've never seen people in my life be more generous.
Really? Yeah. And how long personally?
I've been here a day.
One day. How long personally do you plan on staying here?
Personally, probably till the end of the day, but I will be back. I have students at Woodlocks.
Right. What about yourself?
I'll just be here for the end of the day.
Okay, thank you so much.
Can I ask how long you'll be
here? Pardon me?
How long will you be here for?
Oh, well, I just got here, so who knows?
And what are you filming for?
A blog. Yeah, I'm based in Washington, D.C. I'm going to put it online.
All right.
Thank you.
Take care, man.
Keep moving.
Pepper spray has been deployed at close quarters against people who were pretty much who kettled in.
campus parade was targeted exclusively against women. And so this is New York City in action. This is everyone out there who is within driving distance of the city. You can get here within the next 12 hours. Get down here now. This is your country. Stand up independent.
Yeah.
The whole world is watching. The whole world is watching.
Use that tag.
Buenas tardes. Vengo de España, de Madrid. Soy la indignada del 15M. En nuestra Plaza Sol hubo 30.000 personas acompañándonos en este momento. Aquí somos muy pocos. Nos estamos esperando. Os suplicamos todas vuestras comunidades de vecinos, todos vuestros amigos, todos vuestros familiares, se enteren de lo que está pasando.
What I sort of like it.
The 30th, 1789, standing on a balcony on the steps of City Hall. They then converted this into a federal hall with the Greek style architecture on the outside, mimicking our democracy, you know, to represent our democracy. This then becomes the sub-treasury after the government moves to Philadelphia.
You are all outraged. So it'd be really great.
That's many of you.
Mic check!
There's going to be a working group!
On democracy and process!
At five!
Over there!
Heading out of Roanoke, got a trucker out of Philly, had a nice one too.
Congress! That's all group! We're more bad!